गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टूडेज टॉपिक इज चैप्टर 10, माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर. माइक्रोब्स आर प्रेजेंट एवरीवेयर इन सॉइल, वाटर, एयर, इनसाइड आवर बॉडीज एंड दैट ऑफ अदर एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स. दे आर प्रेजेंट इवन एट साइट्स वेयर नो अदर लाइफ फॉर्म्स कुड पॉसिबली एग्जिस्ट, सच एज डीप इनसाइड द गीजर्स where the temperature may be as high as 100 degrees centigrade, deep in the soil, under the layers of snow, and in highly acidic environments. Microbes like bacteria and many fungi can be grown on nutritive medium to form colonies. They can be seen with the naked eyes. Microbes cause a large number of diseases in human beings. They also cause diseases in animals and plants. Several microbes which are useful to man in diverse ways. Some of the important contribution of microbes to human welfare are discussed in this chapter. So in this chapter we will discuss about the microbes which are useful to the mankind. Next topic is microbes in household products. In this chapter, you have to learn the name of the microbe and its contribution. So in your copy, divide the page into two parts. On one side, write the microbe and on the other side, write its function. Common example is the production of curd from milk. Microorganisms such as lactobacillus and others commonly known as lactic acid bacteria, LAB, grown in milk and convert it into curd. During growth, the LAB produces acid that coagulate and partially digest the milk protein. A small amount of curd added to the fresh milk as inoculum or starter contains millions of lactic acid bacteria which at suitable temperature multiply, thus convert milk to curd, which also improves its nutritional quality by increasing B12 vitamin in our stomach too. The LAB, that is lactic acid bacteria, play very beneficial role in checking disease causing microbes. So from this paragraph, learn the microbe lactobacillus and what is its function. It converts milk to curd and it increases the vitamin B12 content of the milk when it changes into curd. The dough, which is used for making food such as dosa and idli, is also fermented by bacteria. The puffed up appearance of dough when the dough increases in size is due to the production of carbon dioxide gas. Can you tell which metabolic pathway is taking place resulting in the formation of carbon dioxide? Here, in anaerobic respiration. In anaerobic respiration, first glucose changes into pyruvate, then pyruvate under anaerobic conditions changed into ethyl alcohol, carbon dioxide and energy that you have already studied. It occurs in the case of yeast. Where do you think the bacteria of this fermentation came from? From the air. Similarly, the dough, which is used for making bread, is fermented using baker's yeast. The scientific name of baker's yeast is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. A number of traditional drinks and foods are also made by fermentation by the microbes. Here the microorganism, you will write Saccharomyces cerevisiae, and function is help in fermentation of traditional drinks. A traditional drink of toddy, a traditional drink of some parts of southern India, is made by fermenting sap from palms. Microbes are also used to ferment fish, soybean, and bamboo shoots to make foods. Cheese is one of the oldest food items in which microbes were used. Different varieties of cheese are used by their characteristics, texture, flavor, and taste. The specificity coming from the microbes used. For example, a large holes in Swiss cheese. Important lines. Question can be asked, what is the reason for large holes in Swiss cheese? This is due to the production of large amount of carbon dioxide. And which bacteria is responsible for this? And the bacterium named Papinobacterium schermini is responsible for the large holes in Swiss cheese. The Roquefort cheese are ripened by growing a specific fungi on them, which give them a particular flavor. So from this paragraph, Saccharomyces cerevisiae microbe important, and next is the bacterium Papilionobacterium schermini. These names are important. Learn the names and learn their uses also. Next is microbes in industrial products. Even in industry, microbes are used to synthesize a number of products valuable to human beings. Beverages and antibiotics are some examples. They are produced in industries. Production on an industrial scale requires growing microbes in a very large vessel called fermenters. The fermenters are the large vessels in which these microbes are grown for the production of beverages and antibiotics. Next is fermented beverages. Microbes, especially yeast, have been used for time immemorial for the production of beverages like wine, beer, whiskey, brandy, and rum. For this purpose, the same yeast, name of the yeast is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, used for bread making and commonly called brewer's yeast, is used for fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol. As I have already told you that during anaerobic respiration, breakdown of glucose first changes into pyruvate and then into ethyl alcohol, carbon dioxide, and energy is produced. Do you recollect the metabolic reaction which results in the production of ethanol by yeast? Already I have discussed. Depending upon the type of raw material used for fermentation and the type of processing, with or without distillation, different types of alcoholic drinks are obtained. So, under this process, from the raw material, different types of alcohols are obtained. Wine and beer are produced without distillation, whereas whiskey, brandy, and rum are produced by distillation of the fermented broth. Broth means a type of soup. The photograph of the fermentation plant is shown in figure 10.5. So here the different large scale vessels are shown, which are known as fermenters. Next topic is antibiotics. Antibiotics produced by microbes are regarded as one of the most significant discoveries of the 20th century and have greatly contributed towards the welfare of human society. Anti in Greek word, that means against. Anti means against and bio means life. Together this means against life. So actually they are against, antibiotics which are taken against the bacteria. So antibiotics are chemicals, substances which are produced by some microbes and can kill or retard the growth of other microbes, mainly bacteria, that which causes disease. You are familiar with the commonly used antibiotic penicillin. Do you know that penicillin was the first antibiotic to be discovered? And it was chance discovery. Alexander Fleming, the name of the scientist who discovered penicillin, while working on स्टेफिलोकोकी बैक्टीरिया वंस ऑब्जर्व्ड अ मोल्ड ग्रोइंग इन वन ऑफ हिज अनवॉश्ड कल्चर प्लेट्स अराउंड विच स्टेफिलोकोकी कुड नॉट ग्रो व्हेन अलेक्जेंडर फ्लेमिंग वॉज वर्किंग इन हिज लैब इन द अनवॉश्ड प्लेट कल्चर मीडियम ऑन द साइड्स ही सॉ दैट स्टेफिलोकोकी कुड नॉट ग्रो ही फाउंड आउट दैट It was due to a chemical produced by the mold and he named it penicillin after the mold Penicillium notatum. However, its full potential as an effective antibiotic was established much later by Ernest Chain and Howard Florey. This antibiotic was extensively used to treat American soldiers wounded in World War II. Fleming, Chain and Florey were awarded the Nobel Prize in 1945 for this discovery. After penicillin, other antibiotics were also purified from other microbes. Antibiotics have greatly improved our capacity to treat deadly diseases like plague, whooping cough, diphtheria, leprosy, which used to kill millions all over the globe. Now for them, antibiotics are there. Today, we cannot imagine a world without antibiotics. Till here only. Next part, we will continue next time. I hope this is clear. Make in your copy, divide the page into two parts and one part write, one side write microbes name and on the other side its usage. It is important because in the exam such type of question usually comes. Thank you.